that was a big challenge for me. When he hired me, he said, look, I want you to play a parody of you, a spoof, make fun of yourself. I said, yeah, I could do that. I do it every day anyway. Or at least my wife and my kids make fun of me every day. But the challenge was, okay, party like the 80s, you know, all that stuff, fine. But it's not really me. It's pieces of me. It's parts of me. So when Seth presented the script to me, well, there were some speeches in there that I said, Seth, I can't do this. I mean, he had a 3-page speech that I was to deliver on the benefits of doing hard narcotics. I said, Seth, I said, look, I could get away with some of these things, some of that, but I said, I got a pretty big fan base with the kids and all that. And I said, if I'm doing me but not really doing me, I don't want them to think it's really me doing that. So I can't do it. So you know what he said to me? He said, take it or leave it. Okay? He said the studio, Universal, because this was my first big movie in quite a few years, right? So he said, so basically the studio said, either you do this or you're not doing the movie. So what does a smart man do? Right? A smart man goes directly to his wife. Okay? That's what a smart husband does. And I said, honey, I said, this is the deal. And she said, well, we're going to pray about this. So we prayed about it. You know, it's not as though we heard any big voices. But she said, you know what? Say yes, but I've got a very good feeling that it's not going to happen. I said, honey, we're 2 days away from shooting this first scene of the movie. So sure enough, 2 days later, so I told Seth, I said, okay. Tell the studio, I said, okay. I show up 2 days later on the set to shoot this first scene, and Seth came running up to me from a distance screaming, Sam, you're not going to believe it. You're not going to believe it. But the studio just pulled the whole speech. That's answered prayer, and that's listening to your wife. Huh?